and welcome to week 3 of Jam Session. Have you been looking for ways to work with others to accomplish something that you couldn't have done on your own, or helping someone else succeed? Me too. It feels good, doesn't it? And I know it's pleasing to God. Well, let's start off today singing praises to God. Stand to your feet and let's worship together.
More beautiful than anyone ever. Every day you're the same, you never change, no, never. You were more beautiful than anyone ever. Every day you're the same, you never change, no, never. How could I ever deny the love of my Savior? You brought me everything, all I need forever. How could you be so good? There is no one like you. There has never, ever been anyone like you. You're so astounding. How could you be so good to me? Eternally, I believe.
Ever start something small and then discover it was fun to take it big? You read an awesome story and then you bring the whole thing to life for your friends and family. You bake a batch of chocolate chip cookies and they taste so good you recruit friends to put on a whole bake sale. And then you use the money you earn to buy bikes for kids who've never had one. You have fun learning a new way to paint. Then you get together with your friends and paint a whole wall. You send a note to encourage someone.
I hope you have a great day.
And you also work with your friends to throw an entire surprise party. God created you to do amazing things on your own, but He designed you to do even more when you work together to share His love. And then others can see God at work in all of you. That's why cooperation is a fantastic way to worship God with your life. Because worship is about more than just singing loud. It's all about living loud.
I love those reminders that worship is so much more than just singing. It's about living a life of worship. And each week, we get to learn more and more from our Bible stories about how to live a life of worship. So in today's story, we go to Luke 5, 17 through 26, where we discover a paralyzed man, a man who cannot walk. And he happened to have some amazing friends. When his friends heard that Jesus was in town, they tried everything to get the man to Jesus. But when they arrived, the place was so packed and they couldn't get in. Instead of giving up, the friends went, oh, I almost gave it away again. Let's go to our true story from the Bible and see what ended up happening.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 5, verses 17 through 26.
Imagine living in Judea 2,000 years ago. If you got sick, there were very few doctors. If you couldn't see or hear or walk, there was no one you could turn to for help.
Please, help me.
But when Jesus began to travel and teach and heal, suddenly there was hope. A way to get better and start life all over again. Stories of Jesus reached a man in Capernaum who couldn't walk and his four friends. Let's call them Leo, Mike, Raph, and Donnie.
Jesus is in town.
Right here in Capernaum.
Over at Joe's house.
Ginormous crowd, dude.
The man who couldn't walk tried hard not to get his hopes up.
I can't even get there, much less fight my way through a crowd.
You don't have to,
because we got you.
Ready?
Dude, 1, 2, 3, lift!
The four friends each grabbed the corner of the man's mat. Together, they carried him out of the house and down the dusty road. Soon, they could hear the sounds of a large crowd.
There's Joe's place, oh yeah.
What's happening?
People jammed in 20 deep around the door.
We got religious leaders, teachers, poor people, rich people, standing room only.
Actually, there's no standing room, dude. Only room is up.
Sure enough, around the back of the house, the four friends discovered a narrow staircase up to the flat roof.
Wait, how is this any better?
And down, dudes.
Hold it. We can't even hear Jesus.
Oh, we can't hear him yet.
That's about to change.
Help me pry up this clay.
It's time to raise the roof.
Within minutes, the four friends pried up large sections of packed clay to reveal a rough thatch of sticks connecting the roof beams.
Gotta bust these out.
And voila.
As dust and beams of sunlight spilled into the room, the four friends could see the shocked crowd gaping up at them. The only one who didn't seem shocked was the man at the front, watching them with deep, kind eyes.
Jesus!
Hey, all y'all people down there, get ready, because our friend is coming through.
The four friends each grabbed the corner of the mat and began to lower their friend into the rough hole they had created.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, wait,
you can't do this!
In spite of the confusion, the man who couldn't walk was finally lowered to the floor, right in front of Jesus.
Viniv, just look at all this damage.
Jesus wasn't looking at the damage or the shocked crowd. His eyes went from the man on the floor to the four faces peering through the hole in the roof. In their eyes, he'd read what they'd done and how certain they were that he could heal their friend. He saw their faith. Then, Jesus smiled at the man on the floor.
Friend, your sins are forgiven.
The religious leaders didn't dare speak their thoughts aloud, but inside their heads, they were nearly screaming.
Who is this fellow to say such an evil thing?
Who can forgive sins but God alone?
Jesus could tell exactly what was going on in their heads and hearts.
Why are you thinking these things in your hearts? Is it easier to say, your sins are forgiven, or to say, get up and walk?
He wouldn't dare.
At least everyone will see he's a fraud.
Jesus had God's power to meet the greatest need of the man who couldn't walk by forgiving his sins. But that wasn't something the religious leaders could see. So, Jesus gave them something they could see.
I want you to know the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins.
Jesus looked down again at the man on the mat, right into his eyes.
Get up, take your mat and go home.
It seemed that everyone, from the four friends on the roof to the people jammed in the doorways and windows, was holding their breath. The man who couldn't walk sat up. Then he stumbled to his feet. His friends cheered.
Oh, you got this!
Deep breath.
Baby steps.
Bring it, dude.
The man took a step, a hop, a leap.
I can walk. I can walk. Praise God.
The man grabbed his mat and danced out of the house to meet his friends for a group hug. The crowd was amazed and filled with wonder.
Most unusual thing I've seen in all my years.
Well, praise God.
Praise God.
Through the power of God and the help of a few friends, the man who once couldn't walk now ran home on his own two feet. His life forever changed.
Wow, the friends did not give up indeed. They went to the roof and tore a hole big enough to drop their friend down right in front of Jesus. And Jesus did something unbelievable because of their faith and cooperation, right? Sometimes we see others with needs that seem huge and overwhelming, and we often think they're too big for us to help, and we end up doing nothing. However, if we work together to meet those needs, we have a better chance of making a difference in their lives and pointing them to God by showing them the love of Jesus. Well, let's end our time together by saying our Bible verse. Ready? Here we go. Two people are better than one. They can help each other in everything they do. Ecclesiastes 4:9. What a great reminder that is. Well, our hope for you this week is that your heart and eyes are open to look for ways to do just that. We actually have an opportunity as a Hope Kids family to work together and meet the needs of those in our community. On Saturday, March 26th, we will have two outreach events. Join us for one or both. We will be meeting at the Coachella Valley Rescue Mission at 10 a.m. to unload the food and water that we've been collecting. Then at noon, we will be partnering with Angel Tree Ministries as we fellowship at the La Quinta Park for a barbecue and show the love of Jesus to the children in their ministry. Visit hopepd.org and click on events for more details, or email me at dana@hopepd.org. We hope to see you there. Let's pray together. God, we just thank you for what we're learning about, how when we work together, it is so much better than when we do things on our own. And God, when we cooperate together, we can help others to succeed and we can show the love of Jesus and point them to you. And we want to do just that. So put those things in our path so that we can do that and point people to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great week, everybody.